Okay, I'm on vacation and I'm searching for a cellar hall. I'm on the old road. You see the walls on either side of this path here. And as you can see, it goes down there. And I'm seeing a mound over there, just a bit to the right. And I'm pretty sure that's where the cellar hole should be. Now, there's no maps. I didn't look at any maps for this site. I just did a little bit different research. And I just dug up a flat cuff button. It was definitely Colonial, right there. So that's a good sign. So I'll let you know if I get anything else, and I'll certainly record it. So I'll see you later. All right, so I just came up that path. Well, you can see the double walls on each side, and it ran right into this this old tree. It's dying here, and this is the lip, the mound. And sure enough, started sawing the prickly bushes, and the cellar hole is right over here. And this is an old site, you could just tell. This is it here. So you can see it's on a mound here. And so I started swinging, and I got a real iffy signal. And by the way, while I was walking up the path of double walls, I did dig up two flat buttons. And right where my gear is, and this hole is here. Probably about 2.5-3 inches. It looks, sure looks like a copper there. So I haven't pulled it out. I don't know what kind of copper it is. If it is a copper, but I'm almost positive. Let's see what we got. I don't think I'm going to get any detail right this second on it. I'll wipe off a little of the dirt and see if I can get an ID on it. I'll be right back. Alright, so I'm back. I just let it dry out, and I can make it out, and I can even make the date. It's hard to make out the last digit, but definitely a drape bus there. It just focused in there. You can see how it dried out there, and I see 18-0 something. So it's funny, it's weird. I get more drape bust than any copper that I ever dig for some reason. Don't know why. I'm not complaining about it, but definitely a good find. And it looks like it's going to have pretty good detail when I chip away that dirt there. So we'll be back. We'll see what else we can get. All right, I'm on the other side of the cellar hole right now. It's right there, right over that lip. And I'm sort of on the side of the hill. Just pulled out of this hole. Pretty sweet knee buckle frame. Alright, there we go. It's got a nice pattern on it. It looks like it's got some silver gilt. It might be silver plated. I'm not sure. It may be silver plated. That would be really cool if it was, but it's a knee buckle. You can see up there and down there, that's where the pin would have been. So Colonial knee buckle, always fun to find. Let's see what else we get. Spanish silver, or is it Mexican?
I don't know.
So that's a 2 real, I think?
Yeah.
Well, I'm not touching it, dude. You touch it.
Who found it?
Dave.
Oh, I want to take a picture of that.
looks like 1769.
It could be.
Yeah.
1762.
Nice.
Doesn't that look like
1762?
Yeah, definitely.
It's in great shape, dude. Got some really good detail. Darn thing upside down.
This side's beautiful.
Alright, so there's Dave. We just found a site right here, right where that fallen log is. There's a cellar hole there. I'm here with Dave and one of our friends, John, and just dug up a cloak button and an escutcheon plate and a thimble, and just out of this hole right now, I just dug up this colonial cock, this colonial bracelet, and it's got some sort of cut. Either cut glass or some sort of gemstone right in the center there. Never found anything like this. See if I can get a focus for you guys.
That's early, dude.
I'm stoked. So we'll be back. Dave and John are getting attacked by what? By bees.
Huh?
There's a bee's nest right there. No. No shit, it's hanging right over the path.
Huh?
It's hanging right over the path right there. Dave and John just got attacked by they walked through a wasp or what was it, a white hornet?
White face hornet nest.
White face hornet nest.
Look.
It's I don't think I'm gonna be able to use it soon.
Swollen. Dave took a nice header. Running from the bees.
Here's my knee.
Poor Davey. What we would do to find a copper. Here's another cellar hole. A center chimney in there. We're gonna swing around this area, see what we get. And so Johnny just dug up a nice signal. And it is a copper. It looks like
do I get to be on your videos in person now too?
Is that like a copper in your machine?
It sounds like it's popping out a little, but dig it.
What do we got there, Todd?
Oh, man, it's a beautiful drape bus.
Is it?
Yeah.
It looks like it's in nice shape.
It's got good detail.
Wow, look at that, huh? It is good detail.
Let me see if I get bus. This to focus.
Perfect shape.
My elbow.
Oh, yeah. That's a nice shape for coming out of the ground. Look at you can still see the notches in the ring.
Oh, yeah. Beautiful.
Sweet.
There's a really good detail on that.
I know, huh? That's incredible. Look at the notches around the edge.
I've never seen a drape bus with this good detail. Doug, the Liberty can
ring it low, like in low, like mid-70s. Right there.
There's not a button?
No, I don't think so. It's ringing too high for a button. The sound, it was like a mid-70 range, which is like King George-ish. It's a coin. There we go. I'm not sure what this is. I'll be back. Alright, so I just let it dry a little bit and it looks like a hard times token. You see there? you can see the 1 cent, or not 1 cent. Yeah, it says not 1 cent there. I don't know if you can see that. It's a hard times token. Probably like 1830s. Pretty cool though. I haven't really found many of these. Be back.